In this GIMP workshop tutorial, we're going to create magical fantasy image number 10. So relax and enjoy. Go to File and open as Layers. Here we search for our images, select all four of them and click on Open. They will now all open as separate layers in one project. There is a download link for the images in the video description. Go to View, Zoom and Fit Image in Window. Hold the Shift key and click on the eye of the arch layer to make all the other layers invisible. Right-click on the 02 arch layer and hit Add Alpha Channel. Then we right-click on the arch layer again and now we click on Layer to Image Size. In doing so, we've also made this layer active. We can now have transparency in this layer and we can remove the sky. Make in the toolbox the Select by Color tool active. At the mode, we click on the second button, which is Add to Current Selection. Now we can click several times in the sky areas until the whole sky is selected. Go to Select and hit Grow. We grow the selection with 2 pixels. In this way, we get rid of the remaining pixels at the edge of the sky. Hit OK. Now we go to Edit and hit Clear, so the sky is removed. Click on Select and then on None to deselect the selection. Click on Layer in the menu bar and then on Layer to Image Size. Back to the toolbox and now we make the Free Select tool active. We're going to remove the stones on the outer areas. Zoom in by holding the Ctrl key and rolling the mouse wheel. Then we can make a rough selection, more or less like shown in the video. Hold the spacebar and move the mouse to move the image. Click the last node over the first one. Now press Ctrl-Shift-J to maximize the image. Double-click in the selection to confirm. Then we go to Edit and click on Clear to remove the selection. Press Ctrl-Shift-A to deselect. In the next step, we're going to darken the arch image. Go to Colors and Brightness and Contrast. We change the brightness to minus 60 and increase the contrast to plus 25. Hit OK. Click on the New Layer button at the bottom of the Layers panel. Name it Darken Arch. Make the mode Overlay. The fill width should be transparency. Click OK. Right-click on the 02 arch layer and hit Alpha to Selection. Then click on the Darken Arch layer again. Make the paintbrush active and make sure you have black as the foreground color. We will start with an opacity of about 30 and brush hardness 0.25. We make the size about 150. We can change the opacity, the brush hardness and the size as we go along. The front arch doesn't need so much darkening, but the other arches and the left and right side need more darkening. And the end of the hallway should be very dark. Use Ctrl-Z to undo when you've gone too far. Or we can change the foreground background colors to white and paint some light back. This looks especially good in the foreground. And because we have the selection active on this layer, the surrounding area is not affected. Make sure, however, to reset the foreground background colors to their default. Now we will speed up the video. The end result should look a bit like in the video. Make the 02 arch layer active again. Press Ctrl+Shift+A to deselect the selection. Then go to Colors and click on Color Temperature. Change the intended temperature to about 4500. The effect should be a cold bluish color. Click OK. Make a duplicate by clicking the Duplicate button at the bottom of the Layers panel. Click on the downwards pointing arrow to lower it one place in the layer stack. Double-click on its name and rename it Shadow Arch. Hit Enter. Make the Free Select tool active. Make a rough selection of the bottom of the arch image, like so. Click the last node over the first node. Then hit Enter or double-click in the selection to apply. Go to Filters, Light and Shadow, and hit Long Shadow. We make the angle 90 and the length 70. At the composition, we choose the option Shadow Only. Hit OK. Press Ctrl+Shift+A. Now it's time to make the star layer visible by clicking its eye. Then we make it active. In the menu bar, we click on Colors and on Hue Saturation. Here we change the hue to -53, the lightness to -60, and the saturation to -20. Click OK. In the next step, we're going to work on the lamp and the woman with the horse. Click on the eye of the woman layer and make it active. In the toolbox, we click on the Unified Transform tool. There's a link in the top of your screen to a short tutorial about the Unified Transform tool. Then we click in the image to bring up the framework with the transformation handles. Hold the Shift key down to constrain the aspect ratio while we scale the layer. Grab one of the handles at the side of the framework and scale the image like so. Click and drag inside the framework to move the image. When it looks good, we can click Transform. Then we make the layer with the lamp visible and active. And again, we can click in the image to bring up the handles. Hold the Shift key. Transform and move the lamp like so. Then click Transform and Ctrl+Shift+J. Make the layer with the woman active again. Go to Colors and Curves. Adjust the curves like so and click OK. Then we click on the Dodge Burn tool. Make sure that you have the default settings, and if not, you can click this icon to reset them. Zoom into the face of the woman. Then make it a bit lighter using the default settings like so. Press Ctrl-Shift-J again. We're now going to make a shadow of the woman with the horse. Hit the duplicate button. Double-click on the name and rename this layer Shadow Woman. Press Enter. Go to Filters, Light and Shadow, and Long Shadow. In the dialog box we change the angle to 0, and then we change the length also to 0. At the composition we choose the option Shadow Only, and click OK. Make the Unify Transform tool active again, and click in the image. Transform the shadow like shown in the video. No need to hold the Shift key down now. But we can use several different handles, especially the scale and shear handles. When it looks good, we click Transform. Now we can reduce the opacity of this layer to about 95. Go to Filters, and then we click on Blur and Gaussian Blur. Make the blur radius about 5 or 6, and click OK. Then we hit the downwards pointing arrow to place the shadow layer below the woman layer. As you can see, the shadow goes beyond the edge of the floor. To change this, we first right-click on the 02 arch layer. Click on Layer to Image Size. Right-click once more on the layer, and now hit Alpha to Selection. Then we go to Select, and click on Invert. Back to Select, and now to Shrink. We shrink the selection with 3 pixels, and click OK. When we do not do this, there still would be a small line visible where the selection was. Make the Shadow Woman layer active again. Go to Edit and click Clear to delete the unwanted part of the shadow. And to Select and then to Deselect. Make the Woman layer active. Go to Colors and Color Temperature. Make the intended temperature about 9000 and click OK. Click on the lantern layer to make it active. Then click on the new layer icon at the bottom of the layers panel. Rename it Light Small. Make the mode normal. And hit the OK button. Make 2 duplicates of this new layer. Double-click on the name of the top layer and rename it Light Ground. Hit Enter. Double-click on the name of the layer below this one and rename it Light Large. And again, hit Enter. Make the Light Small layer active. And in the toolbox we make the paintbrush active. Then we click on the foreground color of the foreground background colors. In the color palette we fill in the HTML notation F, F, C, C, and 0, 0. So we get a bright yellow color. Hit Enter and then click OK. We start with an opacity of about 50 and brush hardness 0.25. The size should be 50. Zoom into the lantern. Make, by clicking several times, a bright spot in the center of the lantern. Then make the size about 300. And click once to make a nice halo. Make the Light Large layer active and move it to below the lantern layer. Now we make the opacity about 25. And we change the size to about 1300. Press Ctrl-Shift-J. Then we can click once or twice in the lamp again. Reduce the size of the brush to about 500. Now we right-click on the 02 Arch layer and hit Alpha to Selection. This selects everything that's not transparent. Make the light ground layer active. The selection is now applied to this layer. Move it to below the woman's shadow layer. Click a few times on the ground, like so. Because of the selection, the light stays within the selection line and doesn't go outside the edges of the stones. When we're satisfied with the result, we click Ctrl-Shift-A to deselect. And there's our final result, Magical Fantasy Image number 10. I hope that you enjoyed this tutorial. Please do not forget to give a thumbs up and to post a comment to support my channel. Thank you very much for watching.